Welcome back. The Konshens brand, some will argue, is ideal for what dancehall artists should have to fully exploit their global potential. But all of a sudden, the Gala Bubble singer is embroiled in a number of feuds with names like Demarco, Aidonia, Corey Todd, and the man he, Konshens, introduced to us earlier this year. We're talking about Masicka, who was our guest right here on stage last week.
If me go stand up for Subconscious,
yes,
and the leader now stand up for me, then it really and truly don't make no sense.
Today, Konshens is here to respond. Our very special guest right now, right here on stage. Konshens, welcome, sir.
Welcome.
Good to have you. Yeah. All right, so explain for me what's going on with your brand. What's going on with you?
My brand is steady building.
It's still built.
Steady building.
Not affected by all these,
no,
these views.
My standpoint is more addressing issues to my fans. Mm-hmm. You understand? It's not necessarily in response to what a man say or trying to respond to the man.
Okay.
To individuals, but to the broader scale of people, to my fans.
Okay, so but all right, so let's take them one by one.
Yeah.
Masicka last week,
mm-hmm,
he is no longer part of your Subconscious music.
Yeah.
Why so?
I think differences in direction. Mm-hmm. You understand, it is being presented from Masicka's point of view as a loyalty issue. Mm-hmm. But we can just lay it out on the table right now. Him say, me invite Aidonia to Kid Street and invite Popcorn to Kid Street, and he's actually feuding with these artists.
Okay.
Seeing Aidonia the feud, I know about it. You understand? Me know everything. So me not gonna go on like me don't know about it and go on like I was against it. Because from my point of view, it's lyrical confrontation. Nothing wrong with that in a dancehall music. You understand? So I did okay the feud. The last time I talked to Aidonia was, I think, in January. We're in a parking lot. We're not friends like that where we link up regular, but we have respect for each other. If we cross paths, you understand? That was the last time. Popcorn, I see Popcorn more often on the road too. We never know say Masicka and Popcorn have nothing. But even if them have issues, if me I keep a Kid's Street and me reach out to Aidonia and reach out to Popcorn for come be a part of it, that is no business of Masicka. You understand? This is something between me and the kids. Them. I don't care what
happened
between Masicka.
So why didn't you? He says you didn't reach out to him.
I don't reach out to Aidonia for the treat. I don't reach out to Popcorn. Popcorn and Dario are good friends. I'm in Europe. I come back today. The Kids Street keep tomorrow. I didn't call anybody from Subconscious. I never called Dario, Delos, Javad, or Tamali, nobody. But all of them show up because whose show is it? It's mine.
Okay.
So just out of respect, everybody just forward. And even if it was a case where I did invite these artists, them artists are giant in the music, and I'm not going to make a simple lyrical confrontation between them and Masicka prevent me from doing something that will benefit
children,
the kids. I'm going to like some money, I invite them, or a friend, look.
Okay, got you. So those are the big reasons why there is a split?
I think he's a good artist, a great artist.
Okay.
You understand? I bring him on your program to introduce him to the world. So, you know, so I believe.
Did you do anything for him? Subconscious,
yeah,
you think?
Yeah.
You did?
Yeah. We premiered videos here.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? With the CD promotion. All right. I did nothing for him. I only did songs, videos, physically carry him and pass out CDs with my hand and carry make him pass out CDs.
Okay.
Email him songs to DJs and email videos to TV programs, do collaborations. But me not do nothing for him though.
Okay. Do you still have a relationship with Corey Todd?
We are trying to close out the business relationship that we have finally. I may have a little struggle with it, but it'll get done.
So there's no more?
There's no more Kanzi 876. It has been discontinued for a while now, for about a month now.
Why?
Internal differences. You see, it's a number of things we really put together to lead us to the point where we're at now. But I'm not the person that come and hear dirty laundry.
So the brand is dead?
Dead, completely. So you can look out for my brand now, February.
Okay.
Where this is just me, not me and partners. I don't have a regret. I'm not saying that Corey Todd and Ramesh are bad people, but you know, a business, you invest, sometimes it works, sometimes it don't work. Sometimes it's just unfortunate that the actual business itself was successful, but internal, small petty things cause between the partners, cause the downfall of the business. So, yeah.
Cases. Where's that? Is that settled now? Resolved?
And yeah, man, definitely. Okay. What happened is, I record a song for him, and him leak the song, and give some people who shouldn't get the song and them leak it. You understand? Apparently, him thinks I'm going to take it more serious than I actually did. And I put him in a situation, seeing where him feel like him didn't, he was in danger. Okay. And looking back at it, from even the very same night I look at him, I say, yes, I can understand why him react that way. Him have a buckle in him and him swing it and run. Him swing it, it lick me ass up. Him jab, him get up, people run him down. All the things go on. It could have been bigger than it was supposed to be. Mm-hmm. And it wasn't give thanks to that.
And
it resolved. So it wasn't a matter of me and him a fight and him lick me the back.
Physically,
and
yeah,
it wasn't that.
You weren't in a physical altercation with him?
No.
A true fist and
no.
Okay. And it is resolved, you say?
Definitely resolved. Yeah.
So you and him on speaking terms again?
From the same night, me and him are talking. But okay. Right now, it's not a back and forth thing when me talk to him, because the things that we discussed and the way how we decided to handle it, him do it a different. The dance all the way. You know, go up on the TV and look like you're big and your mama lick him with the buckle and...
Okay.
But me love it. And everybody for me love it. So, no retaliation. He's a good youth. Right now, he might do some nice song too with some different people and I hope him thing work.
So, Demarco.
Yeah.
Where is that feud? Is there a feud?
It's nowhere.
There wasn't a feud?
There was a misunderstanding and Demarco, I think, took it and he made songs and I don't know if you say. Mm-hmm. There was a Demarco have a program, Talk Your Mind. Mm. I don't like the program because of things that them say personally to if you make joke of other people, misfortunes. Okay. You understand? There's a character named Walk and Talk, which I think is the baddest character on the program. Him said me no hotter than Rami's shirt. And it was very funny for me. I always watch him on the program. But it was until them start for go a little bit too deep into some people's personal life. And me probably take it harder than the people and even take it anyway. Mm-hmm. But it was never a case where I disrespect Demarco or me publicly state seminar like the program until after Demarco did a song and I had to go and speak to my fans now and tell them, say, yo, listen, and this is not something I'm running with, so we don't need the rally. I'm going to need
a
body.
So he made a song and you responded. And okay, so and it's done there, sir?
It's done for me.
Do you think Masicka and him going clash at Sting or so?
I
or
hope
should
so.
Clash?
I hope so.
They clash?
Yeah. It's all nice because Masicka is a young
American.
But as a
man, who wouldn't take on a clash? Would you take a clash, Konshens?
No, sir.
We were assuming
probably,
that
probably
you would.
Probably 4 years ago.
You wouldn't take a clash?
I would. But no, none of my thing. Try to improve none of my thing. My thing is about me more in tune with just, right now, I'm at a space where I just love music. And I'm blessed with for the fact that I get paid for the music. Okay. And that side of something, the confrontation was never in my thing. So if I try pretend like I am that man now.
Okay, good.
It's stupid.
But who do you carry between in the Masicka, the Marco clash?
I don't know. All right, Masicka more lyrical. Mm-hmm. And them have the young people listening to him. But the Marco have more melodies and more punch. So it would have, you know, if we probably put one of them way over this and one way over yes, so no physicality, you know, go on. It'd probably nice.
Would have been a nice, it could be a nice clash. You are perceived as being absent in 2014 from the local scene, Konshens. Is it real or just?
Very real, yeah.
It's real, you're absent. Deliberately so?
Not deliberately, but I know about it. You understand? I saw it coming and I knew that this was going to happen. You understand? Because we tour extended periods back to back. And that is a big issue in Jamaica because out of sight, out of mind, you have to there and nowhere going in and a mix of things. So you find so the extensive tours contributed to me not being present in dancehall for this year.
Do you regret it?
No, I don't. Learning process, because at the same time, you need to be current in Jamaica, but when you have a broad fan base and you have fans from over this and this and this, so them need to see you too. You need to go and present the music, and not many people can have the opportunity. to go and present the music on a regular basis. So I'm one of these people that were free for fly all over the place. So I have to represent Jamaica and represent dancehall music.
Fair enough. But do you recognize Jamaica as your base?
Yes, man.
It is your base?
Yeah.
And if you missed events like Sumfest and Sting and GT, which are catering a lot to dancehall, when a dancehall artist doesn't report, so to speak, to their fans on these platforms in the Jamaican space, physically, aren't they running the risk of being dismissed, forgotten?
No.
You don't think so?
Dismissed and forgotten are them words are not in my thing, not at all.
Okay.
I think these shows what you mentioned are major shows in Jamaica. Why? As an artist, when you're current in Jamaica, you should be on these shows. Mm-hmm. But I don't think anything is mandatory. I don't think you have to do it. You know, my career has always been something different. You understand? The regular thing I go on over there, so I meet over here. So it's not a matter of not having respect or not seeing the value of these shows, but it's a matter of prioritizing, and you can't do the same thing every year.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? And then again, if I met up on them show the last year, I think it is fair to give the show a break this year and try something else and come back fresh next year.
Okay.
Because even though out of sight, out of mind, you still can oversaturate the market, especially a market that it has shrink now, basically, because, you know, quite a front runner has locked up.
So it must be gauged properly.
Yeah, man, you have to know you're doing a business.
You have to know how, when to stay away and when not to stay away.
I mean, in days before now, an artist find a hot song or a hot formula. You see everywhere, every show, with the same show.
Okay.
In Jamaica, go straight across the board until it played out.
Mm-hmm. Well, if you notice, I mentioned just about three or four platforms.
Yeah.
And one is not expecting that you're going to be everywhere overdoing things, but there are certain important platforms where both local and international fans expect a Konshens, a leading dancehall artist, Konshens, and others in the space to appear. To actually report to them. Fans want to see you in the flesh. Forget about what the back end stories may be with promoter, because we know there's a lot of issues back there.
Yeah.
But the fans, they don't understand what are some of the causes, some of the reasons why these artists aren't appearing. And I think they want to see you in the flesh. They want to feel connected to you. They want to feel that you respect them enough to walk on. And some of these promoters notice that the fans will probably hold it against you.
Look at it.
If you don't appear.
Look at it like this. All right? I think coming back to Jamaica, the important thing is to reintroduce yourself to the fans, to reconnect yourself with the fans locally. Right? As far as international fans looking forward to seeing you on this stage, when you tour extensively, these fans see you anyway on smaller stages that are closer to them.
Mm-hmm.
And even on big festivals that give you the same atmosphere as a Sunfest or a Rebel Salute.
Okay.
So it's a matter of just, touch every corner, you understand? We'll go everywhere in the world with the same fans that will come to a Sunfest when they're right at them place like 2 weeks ago. Mm-hmm. You understand? So once again, it's not a case where I think that each of these shows are mandatory. Nobody ever became great by doing what is expected.
Okay. All right, sir.
Come on, respect.
Let's go. All right, there you have him right here in the segment, Konshens. Stay with us when we come back right here on stage, Demarco, and later, Gully Bop. You don't want to miss that.
Remember me to tell you about bad mind, friend. From you turn your back, them on your life, yeah.